Hello everybody, Dr. Carlo here. I haven't posted for a while, mostly because I was without internet and moving, new house, a lot of work to do, but I wanted to post this video to highlight the importance of not just doing EKGs on patients with chest pain, but also doing a second EKG. Medicine is a continuum of disease, and you can't take things one thing in one time, but you have to observe over time, sometimes repeating the same test twice in 5 minutes, 10 minutes, or whatever time. This particular patient showed up to the emergency department because of chest pain, trouble breathing. And the first EKG was really not diagnostic. You have positive isoelectric here, so you have a near normal axis. You have a pretty regular rhythm like so. You have every P conducts to a QRS, PQRS. The ST segments look pretty good. They're not elevated, there's no depressions. Maybe a little bit of PR prolongation. That space here looks a little bit prolonged. But really a non-diagnostic EKG. This looks a little suspicious right here, but the patient had very significant history of tightness, difficulty breathing. It sounded like a heart attack. So the doctor was smart enough to think, okay, this sounds like unstable angina. This sounds like patient's having a heart attack. So a few minutes later, he repeated the EKG, and this is what we got. So let's see what we see. Initially, you know, the rhythm's a little bit slower than the next one. You can see that this looks very different. Those are ST depressions right there. That looks different over here too. But most important is the inferior leads. Inferior leads are number 2, number 3, and AVF. And you can see right here those ST segments. So this is the S. And the T's over here, and you can see how elevated they are. This is an ST segment elevation heart attack, or MI, or a STEMI. And this was just a couple minutes after that first EKG, which was non-diagnostic. So what's really important about just not just EKG reading is clinical judgment, and know that if the patient has the right clinical history, you gotta keep looking, you have to repeat some of the tests, and you gotta observe the patient over time. And not just waiting another half hour, an hour to do this EKG, but do it in 5 minutes, 10 minutes, because you might find out that the patient is truly evolving into a heart attack. This patient was taken to the cath lab, where it was found that he indeed have a coronary artery occlusion, which they had to open with catheterization and stent placement, and did very, very well. This is a very good example of an astute ER doctor. It wasn't me, it was one of my doctors, who was new enough to repeat that EKG and make the right diagnosis, because the clinical picture suggests a heart attack and not something else. So hope you learn a little bit about this. It's not just about EKG interpretation, you know, this is a ST segment elevation in my, but having that clinical judgment and really searching for the cause of the patient's symptoms. All right, see you in the next video. Bye-bye.